All right, so trigonometry students, today I'm going to look at the dot product of vectors, and this will be pretty simple and short. Just crunching out a dot product is a very simple process to do, and then I'll show you what we mean on this from a geometric perspective. Okay, so first of all, if you're given two vectors, I'll just write this as AI plus BJ, or in this form, and then CI plus DJ are in this form, we represent the dot product by a dot. Okay, it's not multiplication, but it looks like it's represented like it's multiplication. So anyway, what you do on the dot product is you just take the product of the inner terms and the product of the outer terms and add them together. Okay, so it's a real simple process to go through. So let's do some examples. On this one, we're going to do U dot V. I'm going to go ahead and just write this down in this format. So we're going to take that vector and do a dot product with this vector. Now, one thing that's kind of important on this is the answer is a scalar. And what we mean by that, again, is it's just a number. So it's just some sort of a number that you're going to get on this then. So it's a scalar. It's not a vector. Okay, so what we do on this is we do a real simple thing. We just multiply the first numbers, we multiply the second numbers, and then we add the result. Okay, so we would get negative 6 plus 28, so that would be 22. Okay, again, it's a scalar, so that's what you get as your answer. All right, very simple. All right. Next thing, let's do this one. So vector U is negative 3 times 4. Vector W is 3.5 and negative 4.2. Okay, so again, what we do is do the first two numbers, negative 3 times 3.5. And then we do the second numbers, 4 times negative 4.2. And then we add the result. Okay, I've got some decimals, so I'm going to pull up my calculator and just do this on the calculator. Now, you can do this if you want to in just one step on your calculator. Negative 3 times 3.5 plus 4 times negative 4.2. And that will give us a scalar. And that's a negative. Oops, that's a negative. Okay, so we get as an answer on that negative 27.3. All right, so simple calculation that you do. All right, and the next one, we're going to do a dot product with the number itself, which you can do. So let's see, we have negative 3.5, negative 4.2, and we're going to do the dot product with itself. Okay, so we just do the same process. Again, multiply the first numbers. Okay, you could actually write this way if you wanted to. And then negative 4.2 squared like that. And then add those together. So I'll just do that again on the calculator here. And then that'll give us our dot product of those two vectors then. All right, so I'll just do this like this. Now it's kind of important if you do the squaring thing like I'm doing there, you know, make sure you have that in parentheses so that the calculator gives you that positive number. And then we'll do negative 4.2 to the second, like that. And that will give us that product then. So that is 29.89 would be the answer of that problem. Okay? So that's how you do the calculations on that. All right, so it's a real simple process. I'm going to let you do a few problems just to make sure you got the handle of it. Shouldn't have any trouble with that. And then I'm going to go through the geometric interpretation of a dot product also. All right, so if you'll go ahead and go down the bottom, and I'll have you try these out, pause the video, and then resume and see if you got the correct results. Okay, so let's see. I'll have you go ahead and check your answers and see if you got these right. I'm sure you did, as long as you did your arithmetic correct. So the first one, the dot product was negative 9. Next one, I got 2.2. And part C, I got 13. Okay, and I just wrote it in this form. So again, you're just doing product of the first terms plus the product of the second terms. If you didn't get those right and you need to pause the video to look over that, then you can do that. I'm going to go ahead and move down to just giving you a geometric interpretation, and I'm going to show you an example of that. I just hate to just teach students how to do a dot product with at least giving a little bit of an idea of what a dot product is. If you're going to take a physics class, and I'm sure most of you probably will take physics, a physics one class, you'll be working with vectors extensively, and you'll see a few applications of dot products, like the work involved in doing something. So there's a concept known as work in physics, right? And it has something to do with a dot product. So what I was going to show you on this diagram right here is this. So you have a vector A, and then this is a unit vector. So it goes like this. So it turns out that what this is the dot product of A and the unit vector is going to end up being this. Now, this isn't just a unit vector. So it turns out to be this piece right here. Okay, it turns out to be the magnitude of A multiplied by the cosine of theta gives you this little slice there. So I like to think of this as a vector projection. And I'll show you where that formula comes from. I'm going to show you that. So it's just this vector being projected onto this vector. You can think of that as kind of like a shadow, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you where this comes from. It's actually real simple to derive this. You have a right triangle, and this piece right here, I'm just going to give that a variable like x. So what you have is you have the cosine of theta is the side adjacent, which is that vector projection, which I'm going to say x, over the hypotenuse, but that hypotenuse is the magnitude or the length of A, like that. Okay, then what you would do is you could multiply both sides of this equation by the magnitude of A, and you would end up getting this quantity. So X is magnitude of A times cosine of theta, and X is, that's what the dot product is. Okay, so it turns out that A dot the unit vector is going to give you this then. Okay, right? Now, what we're going to learn here a little bit later, as I finish this very long section, is you're going to learn that if you just have two vectors in general, A dot B, then it turns out to be the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of the angle in between. And it basically gives you that same vector projection idea. So what I'm going to do is I'd like you to pay attention to this, and if you have room to write this down on your notes, I would have you do that, because I'd like you to just know and get a sense of what a dot product is. So I'm going to take these two vectors, and we're going to graph these two vectors. First of all, if we graphed the vector 6, 0, then that would just be a vector straight on the x-axis like that. And I'm going to write that down. See, the magnitude of that vector A would just be 6. It has a length of 6, okay? And then I'll draw this second vector, which is over 3, up 3, okay, like that. And then I'm going to figure out what the magnitude of B is and put it in that diagram. So the magnitude of B, remember the way we learned how to do this, it's the square root of the sum of the squares. So that would be 3 squared plus 3 squared. So the magnitude of B is going to be 9 plus 9 square root of 18. And I'm just going to leave it that way without simplifying, and that's okay. And then we have an angle theta. And, you know, you could work out that angle, you know, pretty easily by some simple calculations. But I made this up. So it's 45 degrees, all right? So I'm not going to go through where the 45 comes from. I made the problem up so it's that way. Anytime you have a vector with equal values for I and J, it's a 45 degree angle, okay? So what I was going to do on this is a couple of things. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do the dot product of A times B. Okay, so we're just going to do 6 times 3 plus 0 times 3 like you've done. So A dot B would just be 18. All right. Okay, so that's the dot product. Now I'm going to show you how this formula works and gives the same thing. All right. So I'm going to do this basically down here then. All right, so what we're going to do is A dot B, let's do this formula. It's the magnitude of A, which we've already done, times the magnitude of B, times the cosine of the angle in between those two vectors. All right, so what we'd end up getting on this is the magnitude of A is 6, the magnitude of B is square root of 18, the angle in between is the cosine of 45 degrees. So you would end up getting 6 times root 18. The cosine of 45, you could look that up on the unit circle, is square root of 2 over 2. And then what we'd end up having, I just want to show you that you would get an 18 out of that. So basically we'd have this. We'd have 6. You can get a square root of 36 when you multiply that together, all over 2. So that would be 6 times 6 over 2. So that is 36 over 2. So it's 18. So what I wanted to show you is how that formula works. Now what that means is it's given a vector projection on that then. All right, so that would be kind of the idea behind how a dot product works. So a little later on, we're going to learn and look at this formula right there. Okay, all right, so that's what I wanted to show you on that. So that should wrap us up on this real short video. I'm going to go ahead and post this, all right?